Gonna be in mid and bottom lane, and he's gonna need to devote a lot of attention to bottom. Can't let Ashe and Zyra get out of control, because then they will rotate around the map for days. And if they begin rotating, Aurelion Sol and Maokai, they don't tend to fare too well with getting pushed around to other lanes.
Yeah. So you guys can get another second look at both of the compositions of the teams, and this last game is going to decide who will take the series, get another win under their belt. So let's jump into game number three of the Rox Tigers versus the Afrika Freaks right now. Welcome to game three, the Afrika Freaks versus the Rox Tigers. Here we go. Both teams are just going to fan out, as has been the standard in these games so far, and in the LCK in general. Not too many TZ level one plays being made.
No reason to really go aggressive. There is the potential to just throw away all strength in the early game level one. I mean, in the opposite light, you have a lot to gain, but teams just not wanting to risk that. And we're just seeing everyone spread out, and Marin and Kuro might actually just share a little bit of the small raptors. That'll actually let them get level two off of just the first minion wave.
Always an interesting idea, although Spirit's coming over here now.
Not entirely sure what exactly is happening. It's just another little unique route. That's actually very nice. Spirit's able to just clear that instantly, and now he's going to be able to move over to blue buff. And Sungwan can't react to this, going to lose his blue buff for free and get triple buffed. The other problem with this is if Songyun and Ki get too aggressive, the blasting plant is going to come up and enable Spirit to root down immediately. In which case, Sungwan is basically caught between a rock and a hard place, where he's forced to go into a suboptimal three camp clear. Well, then Spirit can then go into a five camp defensive clear of his own jungle.
What do you think? Is Isla Vuv a jungle player? Is he the one bringing out the strats?
Well, bringing out the builds.
Yeah, perhaps. Hold that thought. Kuro is going aggressive. Forces a flash out of Mickey. Even with the exhaust, he's not able to win that trade.
Big question this game is, what is Mickey's mental state right now? Because he does have the tendency to go extremely over-aggressive and then just keep dying over and over and over. And, I mean, mid lane already off to a significantly worse start than game number one. It almost looks like a different lane.
Yeah, it's weird. He was fine to take the trades in game number one, but this time around having a lot more trouble with that. Spirit, he's going to find Sungwan here. He's going to jump immediately onto that and should be able to pick up first blood here. He's going to rappel up into the sky. But here comes Mickey. Okay, he's not going to be able to get that. In fact, the flash coming in here, trying to get onto Spirit. And oh, the blasting plant is able to get him away just barely.
The smite onto the Scuttlecrab to get the HP from Spirit is actually what saved him in the end there. And so, very quick thinking paying off for him, but first blood denied for both parties. Certainly would have had Sungwan had Mickey not been there to show up.
Summoners burn too, both Spirit and Sungwan losing their flash. So we're gonna have a bit harder time engaging for some of these ganks for a bit. But yeah, that's really hard to do under that amount of pressure, to get that smite off and then get into the blasting plant and perfectly get away. You can see the combo that they do down here in bot lane is always so annoying from MF Jhin.
Very obnoxious indeed. Also a nice change of openings, by the way, in bottom. Longsword three pots. This plays more into the lethality changes so that you can get that serrated Dirk that much quicker and have quite an impact early on. Remember, this is 7.2, so if Jin does opt into the lethality builds, he packs quite a punch.
We don't want to see this lane.
We don't want to see that lane. Get us off that.
Can we see another lane?
No, we don't care about this.
Well,
I mean, all right.
We care about this. Yeah, this is
yeah,
cool.
All right, this is cool.
All right.
Only because Spirit. This is a really difficult angle to approach from.
Yeah.
Look at how Shy's positioning in the lane. If he was further down, almost touching the terrain between the two gaps, then he would be susceptible to a gank. But because of where he's standing in the lane, it actually makes him gank immune. And he's just playing in a very good pocket.
Marin is pushing
this.
This
is really forceful.
Okay, they're going to try to go for some kind of dive, I suppose. And I think Shy might be reading this. He's going way back. And, well, you're not going to be able to dive onto him. Nice read from Shy. Maybe some communication from mid lane, too, as Mickey says, okay, Kuro's gone. Something's going on. Oh, hold that thought. Okay. He's going to be forced to flash away as they really committed to that dive. They're still not going to be able to pick up that first blood.
No first blood, indeed. And, I mean, that came at a heavy cost. Spirit just wasted a ton of time. And Kuro as well. You can see that Mickey is already level 6. Mickey got back a CS advantage. And in the meanwhile, Shy didn't really miss out on too much. He missed one melee minion right there. Minion wave is perfect for him. Mickey recalls into a phage. I like that as the first item. It's going to give him some tanky stats, and the passive will certainly enable him to pressure, but also get away from Kuro whenever necessary. And meanwhile, in the jungle, I mean, Sunghwan with the green smite already, going to be able to establish vision control and protect his laners. And Spirit finds himself in a really awkward spot right now.
He's kind of just forced to go back and farm from behind. See if he can catch up in just a bit here. But mid lane, Mickey having the experience lead at least. Kuro not falling too far behind on the farm. Just going to clear out this wave. Mickey actually not going to recall for now. That may be his demise, as it looks like Kuro wants to come in here. Force that trade. Here comes Kha'Zix from the brush. Mickey very low on mana and no Valkyrie. But Spirit being spotted by that control ward, just going to sweep that up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Marin not going to be able to go in onto that one, but does delay the recall.
Delays the recall of Sunghwan indeed. And Marin has a nice little CS advantage up in top. You can just see that on the minimap. Marin also has teleport advantage, and they are able to take the blue buff. Taking that away from Mickey. I don't know what we're looking at right now. Don't need to.
I don't know what that is. It doesn't look like anything to me. Well, nice stun there from Kuro.
Okay. Freakin' out. Gonna recall their bottom lane. And this lines up with Spirit now moving on to the left-hand side of the map. So everything is actually... they're basically playing in harmony.
Yeah. It was kind of weird that dive up and top worked because Spirit lost a bunch of farm and XP. He essentially took farm away from Poppy, but he lost it himself. But I feel like, and correct me if I'm wrong, I feel like Kha'Zix is going to need that farm a little bit more than Poppy here.
Shy actually down about 20 CS, but after he picks up this wave, it should just be 14. But still, that's really big at 8 minutes and 30 seconds into the game. Meanwhile, in bottom lane, Serrated Dirk and Boots of Swiftness actually already completed for Kramer, so any misstep from Songyun or Ki is going to be punished instantly. BF Sword already for Songyun. And in terms of itemization, I mean, take a look at Sunghwan, Sork Penetration Boots as the first item circumventing Aether Wisp, not even going immediately into jungle item or anything, or the mobility boots. Very interesting choice, and trying to coordinate a dive up here.
Well, they're going to get something on Zhongyu in bot lane instead. Tons of damage coming out. Fourth hit does go on the key. The flash, and it doesn't get him. In fact, going to turn that around with an Entranted Crystal Arrow. Nice exhaust onto Sungwan. Can they kill Tushindo? Yes, they do. First blood, but down goes Sungwan himself as well.
Down goes Sungwan as well, but they called in a teleport from Marin, and now they're going to lose their teleport advantage. So nice turnaround by the Rocks Tigers. Afrika ends up salvaging it with a kill themselves on the enemy jungler, but they lost their teleport, and that's really big. Mountain Drake is on the table. Gorky has the package. And it looked like Mickey was trying to make something happen. Meanwhile, Spirit just inflicting as much damage as possible onto Sungwan for choosing to go bottom lane. And all of the camps for Spirit inside of his jungle are going to be up. And Sungwan's not going to have the luxury of being able to invade Spirit's jungle. So Spirit's going to get further and further ahead on camps, experience, and gold. Rubber banding will help Sungwan recover.
Nice pickup for Kuro there. Gets the blue buff. Will be able to push that mid wave in even that much faster. And they took the blue buff away from the side of the Tigers. So going to have a nice little advantage there in the mid lane. And here comes Maokai too. They may want to convert this into something if Mickey goes a little bit too aggressive here. Is going to Valkyrie away. Won't fall for it again.
Now Tushin just clearing out some vision. Spots out Sungwan. And Mickey really not in a position where they would want to start a Mountain Drake attempt. Probably needs a recall right now, needs to get the Sheen, get the components of Trinity Force. Kuro probably recognizes that at this point, constantly just shoving him under, denying his ability to recall. And it looks like Sungwan trying to make his way down to the bottom half of the map, and there is absolutely no vision control. Spirit, in the meanwhile, just endlessly farming.
Trying to catch up, and that he has is almost 10 CS ahead of Elise this point in time. And does have level 8 ahead of her. Definitely not as much of a focus down in the bottom side with the vision control. They go for the curtain call onto Sangyu and do a nice bit of damage, but someone's waiting. They have to be so, oh man, right through the goalposts. And that is going to deny any kind of engage here for the Tigers.
I don't know what we're looking at again.
Yeah, lots of pings were going down, and I guess they were just saying, okay, Spirit's going into your jungle, be careful. And once again, another punish from Spirit. As you were talking about, just wants to take as much away from Elise as possible. No response towards the dragon. And it seemed like they kind of wanted to dive bot, but there's a ward spotting Sungwan here. They may still go for it anyway. Kramer needs to run away. There's the TP. Oh, and this time the Valkyrie coming out from Mickey in mid. So much action right now. Spirit trying to get onto that as well. There's the teleport from Shy this time around. Are they going to turn anything onto Kuro? No, it doesn't look like it.
Shy using his teleport. Now they have to make use of his presence. I feel like it would be very strange to just have him go back to top, but it seems like that is what he's doing. Sungwan, though.
Oh, but no leave to get over the wall, but here comes Kuro. Can he actually land anything? No, it doesn't look like it. Spirit using his ultimate there, too, to try to get that kill. At least he does push Sungwan way, way back, and it looks like they want to go for the dragon now.
So it looks like Afrika going to be able to pick up the Mountain Drake. It's a big pickup indeed. And meanwhile, Kramer probably just going to shove in this last wave and then look for a recall. And now Marin comes back to top lane, and they didn't accomplish anything off Shy's teleport. And it ultimately just completely wasted.
So Afrika in a pretty nice spot. There's only been two kills so far in this almost 15-minute game, but they still do have a 1,000 gold lead and the first Mountain Drake. Second Drake that comes up is another Mountain Drake. So if they get two, they're going to be shredding those objectives super quickly. Stun landed, but no follow-up.
Okay. right now. They might look to make something happen with a dive here. And this would give them first blood turret as well.
Oh man, nicely done. Just the flash into the Twisted Advance. No response for Mickey, nowhere to go. Nicely done, there's that kill. We'll see if they can turn that into a turret here. Shy going pretty deep into the jungle. Just gonna be walking by. They know they can't kill each other, so not going to take the fight. Just gonna go back to lane and try to get that farm.
And so in the replay here, we see that Marin's basically just gonna be able to get onto Mickey. He has absolutely no way out, and I thought that after this, they would be able to stay for one extra wave, hard shove it, and get the first blood turret, given the damage that was already inflicted. But Sung Hwan actually made his way over to mid lane and locked himself up there. Nonetheless, this is really bad for the ROX Tigers right now.
Yeah, ROX Tigers really eating a ton of damage there from the curtain call. One more push and they might be able to get the turret, but Mickey coming in is a bit scary. He does have the big package. Are they going to commit? That is the question. It's 4v4 down here. Marin does have the TP, whereas Shy does not, but it looks like still Frieka is just going to back off for now, just leaving Jin down there in bot.
Ki and Sung Hwan trying to get some sort of vision control around Spirit's red side jungle, misses the cocoon. Mickey, okay, poking Spirit a little bit. Marin clearing out the minion wave. And Kramer is gonna get first blood turret of the game.
That's quite a lot of gold for him. 650, and also going to be comfortable enough to push that next wave. Has to be careful with Zyra hanging around. Sangyun does have his enchanted crystal arrow up.
We're not seeing ROX really do anything this game. And it's just basically Afrika slowly but surely getting constant leads. And this time around, the Tigers, they don't have that same luxury they had in the previous two games.
All the slow coming in into the stun. Shy forced to flash away. The slow coming in, and there's the Twisted Advance. Someone is around, though, to help out. Look at how Shy just does not die, especially to the pretty much non-existent damage of Maokai. They're just both forced to run away. Here comes the arrow. Ooh, it does hit him.
What is that hitbox?
I know, it hit the wall, and it has such a long stun. And there you go, Kuro knocked up. It looks like someone will live. Mickey might pay for it. He tries to flash the wall, but fails. Valkyrie is gonna work out. Oh man, the bullet time. But Mickey still does live. Now it's Shy's turn to try to get into the action. But against three members of Afrika, he will not be able to secure a kill.
Not able to secure a kill. Kuro gonna pick up his blue buff. Not quite sure what Mickey's doing right now. Looks like he's clearing Wraith Camp, but he already has the Trinity Force, so I'm not sure if the delay of his recall is that worth it instead of him just getting back onto the map. Meanwhile, Sangyun now up in top lane. And, I mean, that was a very bizarre turn of events. I really felt like that arrow wasn't gonna hit, but it took a page out of Morgana's book.
That was pretty intense, man. That's a really thick arrow. Here comes Kuro again. He wants revenge for the arrow. Oh, gets the slow, then forced to flash away from the stun.
Sangyun now missing his flash. The two primary carries for ROX Tigers now are gonna be summonerless for the upcoming Dragon and Baron, and it's another Mountain Drake. You can't just give that to Afrika for free. If you do that, their ability to shred Baron, it's only gonna take them a few seconds, and their turret pushing capability is gonna be basically irresistible.
Jin's gonna shoot once, the tower's gonna lose half health. Wow, Tushin with the Nikes, man. Oh boy, he's not gonna live, just barely in the end. It looks like someone might pay for it with his life. The teleport coming in, Spirit's gonna secure the kill. They get the slow onto Sangyun, one more hit should. Oh, but nice block there from Mickey. Marin is still going deep. Uh-oh, Spirit getting locked up as well. Marin now being slowed. Oh, here comes Kuro, Voice of Light coming in. And he should be able to take out multiple members. That's gonna be two. Down goes Ki to Marin, and a big wipe there as only Shy is left over to push bot lane.
Shy is pushing bot lane and he's doing what he can, but not really doing too much. Almost a 5,000 gold lead, certainly will be after they take this mid turret, and everything is just going right for Afrika right now. And, I mean, going forward into this game, I don't really know what the Rocks Tigers are going to do. Afrika going to pick up the second Mountain Drake. Herald is going to die to itself quite soon and enable Baron to enter the Rift. And just looking at it, they have no summoners. They can't take a team fight. They don't really have the items to threaten Afrika with almost anything. And so they're brought down to relying on to an Enchanted Crystal Arrow or Cocoon to make picks. And
look at Tushin.
A look at this replay. Tushin jukes it, jukes that one too, but ends up being brought down by Mickey. And when the curtain call comes out, Songyun unable to really be protected by anyone. Right there though, the last hit, Mickey gets locked up and Spirit trying to bring him down. Marin didn't quite have the damage, but when Kuro showed up with the Voice of Light and all the damage coming out from him, they're able to finalize the kill and pick up tons of objectives.
Kuro with the cleanup, crew coming in with the mop, wiping them up, and it was pretty enjoyable to see. Tushin, he didn't really get to get his ult off or do too much damage, but he baited Rox into an unfavorable position. Some Faker level psychic knowledge coming out of him. Shy now kind of getting caught in the jungle, going to be stunned up, forced to knock Marin away.
6k gold lead now for Afrika, and they can basically do whatever they want.
You know what's going to happen is Afrika's going to win the game with 66.6 thousand gold. The devil's going to show up and be like, I am the master of Summoner's Rift after all.
Devil Teemo. Comes up from the Nexus. And right now, it's just going to be a little bit of a fight over vision on the left-hand side of the map. Dragon not coming up for a very long time. And even if it does, it is the worst dragon in the game. Bulbasaur himself.
Poor Bulbasaur, man. Water Drake actually does look kind of green. You know, not just blue.
It's teal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, it's like a shiny Bulbasaur. It's a little bit better, I guess.
Took a quick glimpse of bottom lane, and we just get to see how nothing is ever really accomplished.
You're like, oh, my mistake. Yeah, I gotta get out of there.
We see Sungwan actually going into the Leandres for his build, but it's not really going to accomplish too much as there's a lot of magic resistance on Afrika already.
Oh, nicely done. He does have the cleanse, but oh boy, a huge amount of damage and stun coming out there. He's only going to trade for Zyra, but Sungwan and Songyun, they are on the run. Teleport coming in. Tushin wants blood, so does Spirit. He's going to jump onto Mickey, but he gets exhausted. Shy might be able to follow up onto that one. A little bit indecisive for where he wants to go. Going to turn around onto Tushin, knocks Kramer up. Just backs off, but here comes Marin from behind the curtain call. Oh man, they Shy with the big block there at the end, but it's just not going to matter as many of these members go down. Spirit's going to pick up the kill in the back. And Shy, although he does kill Spirit in the end, Afrika taking another great trade here. They might be able to pick up Shy here too.
Oppie just doesn't die. Kramer unable to get the fourth bullet onto Shy. Shy flashed away as it was ready. And while they do sustain and live, Mickey gets away. He played a very big part in turning that fight around. Afrika still comes out ahead, able to secure vision control now around Rox's red side jungle. And they're gonna be able to reset off of this. And I mean, that was almost a best case scenario. They landed an Enchanted Crystal Arrow and they locked up Kuro, but as soon as he was basically freed, the damage output that came out from him and Tushin was just enormous. And we can see this again. So Kuro gets locked up, he cleanses that immediately. Cocoon comes out, and just look at the damage coming out from Bullet Time and Kuro. Songyun and Sungwan barely escape, but Tushin and Spirit were basically hot on their tail. Mickey was coming up, and he did have the cleanse, so Spirit couldn't quite kill him. Shy coming in, but unable to really find something that he could do. Snapcast his ultimate, but his teammates were out of position. Meanwhile, back in live, Kuro somehow found a way to die in the middle of the lane.
That just looked like he was out of position. And speaking of out of position, looks like Spirit Almost got out of position and almost killed Sung Hwan in the meantime. Just both junglers getting extremely low.
Dragon coming up in just under a minute here. Shy trying to get the top turret, but Marin and Tushin are on way to put an end to that.
Yep, no shenanigans up there coming out of Poppy. Oh, he actually getting locked up. Going to spark this curtain call coming out. He going to eat three of those shots. Sangyun eating one for his teammate. Nobody goes down.
Now just going to push in mid lane.
Oh, you got spotted there.
It looks like Sungwan's actually just electing to stay on the Haunting guys and go into Void Staff to deal with the magic resistance that is coming out for Afrika. But really, I just don't think that it's going to matter. But he doesn't really have anything else to do because Shy's not going to offer any sort of damage.
Yeah, he's not going to do much. Mickey trying to come in here and poke, and actually Afrika is going to back off. They don't commit to the Baron. Marin coming from the right side. Kramer eating a bit of damage though on the left. Look at that poke from Corki. This is going to force Afrika back. And they cannot take that one. Meanwhile, Botwave is able to clear up the tier 1 turret.
Minions doing more than Shy ever did.
Very true.
As they managed to take the turret. And it looks like Marin, he's got that home guard bonus. Can he find a way?
Unless he wants to 1v4. Nice read there from the Rocks Tigers. So we have Ocean Drake here. They're going to reluctantly take it.
And they do take it indeed, and that will make one more dragon spawn, another Mountain Drake. So the next dragon of the game being Mountain, I mean, Rocks can't let Afrika have three Mountain Drakes.
Yeah, it just can't happen, basically. You don't want Kramer one-shotting your turrets. Or even Tushin, for that matter. And look at all the vision around the Baron now. Afrika's been trying to set this up for a very long time.
There's a giant fight over vision inside of Rox's red side jungle. For the most part, Afrika have been on top of their game. Thus far, at least, controlling it. Double Mountain Drake again. They can shred Baron so quickly.
And there's no vision. That one ward, it's controlled. Hawkshot comes in. Now they see it. Now they're making their move. Teleport is coming in. Can they get the steal? No! Nicely done there by Spirit to secure that Baron. And now the curtain call coming out. They want to turn this around. Look at Sohan up top, but also look at Shy. He's going to eat all of that damage in the front and will go down. So a nice turnaround there for Afrika.
Huge turnaround for Afrika. Now with the Baron buff, double Mountain Drake. This push is going to be quite unstoppable. He does not have his ultimate available. They still do have the Enchanted Crystal Arrow, but it's not really going to mean too much. Look at how quick the turret just falls. They don't have the proper wave clear or ammo to really deal with this. The inhibitor certainly going to fall. Look at Sung Hwan down in bottom. He just got the recall off.
Yeah, every time those guys attack that turret, it just loses so much health. And they're actually going to back off there. They're not going for the inhibitor. Looks like they want to go buy first, using all of that gold they just got.
Stockpiling a lot of gold. We can take another quick look at the replay. No blasting plant available to Sung Hwan, and he didn't have time to try to get into the pit via a rappel, so forced to try to flash in, failed, and then at this point, Shy's locked up inside of the pit. You can see that Mickey's trying to do whatever he can, but it just didn't really matter. And then the rotation into mid lane was basically unstoppable. Now Marin escorting minion wave up bottom. Shy going down there to try to protect it, but they're going to be forced to concede this turret. There's no reason to try to protect it. It would be quite a mistake. Meanwhile, though, up in top lane, they have a gigantic wave pushing in their favor that might end up actually shredding the top turret if Rox can hold on a little bit.
Down goes turret number 2 in the bot lane. Keep in mind, they still haven't taken the inhibitor in mid. So you see Kuro pushing in there at the same time. Just kind of going in between the two lanes. It looks like now they're all grouped up in bot. And the curtain call comes out. Sniping Sangyu in the back will be blocked there by Key. But now Shy, you know, he's tanky, but look at all that damage coming out there from Kramer, able to pick up the kill. Now it's a 5v4. And it's going to be increasingly just that much harder to stop this push.
And now Afrika have their eyes set on the inhibitor. They destroy that really quickly. And now Marin threatening the ability to basically go on any of the carry. Sangyun and Mickey cannot pull.
This is what the Maokais always do. Uh-oh, someone getting... Oh boy, he's going to go down immediately. Jin takes out the turret too. And Marin in the front, you can't really get past him. And that's going to be two turrets, two inhibitors going down, and a huge Baron power play for the Afrika Freaks. Nice stops there by Kramer. Spirit's going to be denied his recall, but will eventually get there.
Kuro just making sure that the minion wave constantly stays shoved in. Rock's unable to advance onto the map to do anything right now. And now top lane's going to be the focus with both bottom and middle inhibitor down. And just taking another quick look at the replay, Sungwan got locked up. Marin didn't want to go in. He could have with the flash, but knows that it's basically not necessary to commit that hard. And Spirit just able to delete Sungwan, and I don't think he was expecting that kind of damage.
So Afrika, they've looked a lot more grouped up as a team. You know, you were talking about how the Rocks Tigers weren't really doing much in the early stages. And Afrika was playing a little bit more passively, but finally they made stuff work. They took fights, they took big objectives, and they're looking a lot more organized in games two and three.
Afrika looking way better in game number three, and the problems that ROX has been having this split is if they're not getting outright advantages from team compositions, their ability to play a standard or a traditional team comp is just not really there. And so when they're forced into these scenarios of standard versus standard, where there is no, you know, as I always call it with them, smoke and mirror type things, then it just leaves much to be desired.
See Kramer gets stunned up there, not able to fully channel the curtain call, but it just doesn't matter because he pushes everybody back and it gives them so much space around that turret. That should be the third inhibitor going down. Looks like Afrika's in a good spot to take this one. Kuro is going to be jumped on in mid by Shy, but he doesn't do any damage. So they take down the third inhibitor. Nexus turret's taking a bunch of damage, and this is the last desperate attempt from the ROX Tigers to try to make something work. Marin eating a ton of damage, as does Kramer, but Shy jumping on in, and that was the big mistake that they needed. Afrika going to take him out. Mickey is going to Valkyrie, and Marin gets sent all the way back into the spawning pool. And down he does go. And so this is actually going to force Afrika back as they're not safe without their big tree in the front. That was a nice play by Mickey.
That was a very good play by Mickey, able to bring Marin in there. And now they're just going to turn their attention to the third Mountain Drake of the game for them. I'm going to pick that up. Elder will spawn if the game is allowed to get that far. But I can't see it going that long. Mm. Not with one Nexus turret remaining and triple inhibitor down.
Triple inhibitor, triple Mountain Drake, and Baron about to spawn. Can the Tigers even get out of their base to contest Baron? That's the first question. And they definitely cannot stop the push with all these super minions and the Baron buff and the three Mountain Drakes. So a very dire situation for them. They're going to have to go back to the drawing board, no doubt, after tonight and find out what they're doing wrong.
It's going to be a work in progress for the Tigers because watching them play anything... Well, here's the Spirit Bomb. Goku's here.
Yep. Coming on in, and meanwhile, they're not even going to need it in the back here. It looks like someone almost goes down. Spirit trying to make it work with Marin after he does teleport in. Kuro will eventually take out Shy in the back, and that is going to be the end of the game. Afrika trying to clean up the rest of them in the back. Tushin with the bullet time. He wants to get his KDA a little bit more up there. Guerrero's going to jump in for the kill, and he gets it. GG. Afrika win the series 2-1.
And that was a much better third game from Afrika, and it's the type of team composition that I wanted them to use against Grox, because on paper, they have better players. And when you have better players, and statistically, if we're just looking at it from a raw muscle standpoint, they should just be able to go up against Rocks. And if Rocks don't have some weird, wonky team comp with split pushes and lots of globals, there should be no world in which Afrika doesn't come out on top. So Afrika suffers another loss, and just watching their games, it basically, you know, as I mentioned earlier, it's a lot left to be desired where they can't play normal team compositions without just looking like one of the teams that is going to go into relegations. And they really need to get it together. We're in week four. We're almost halfway done with Spring LCK. And they need to change a lot.
Yeah, Rocks Tigers definitely struggling a lot so far. A pretty disappointing loss there. They got close. But game three specifically just did not go their way. So back to the drawing board with them. Afrika looks pretty happy. They look relieved more than anything. Both Kuro and Marin sitting back in their chair and lifting their hair. They're like, man, that was close. We almost lost that series. But a pretty dominant game three at the very least.
To see what both of these teams can do going forward. Still have a lot of work cut out for both of them if they want to contend with the giants that are SKT and KT.
Yeah, so guys, we are going to head to the analyst desk and find out who the MVP is of game number three and go ahead and interview those two. So stay tuned, we'll be right back.